Hola, ¿qué tal? Bienvenidos a Estrategias de Inversión. Cada vez son más compañías las que se han lanzado a emitir bonos convertibles, ya saben, esos híbridos entre las acciones y la deuda. Vamos a hablar de cuáles son las perspectivas de este mercado y para eso tenemos a Luke Olsen, gestor de convertibles europeos de Aberdeen Asset Management. Nice to see you in this set.
Thank you.
La primera pregunta que le quiero hacer es, bueno, ¿cuáles son las perspectivas para que tiene para el mercado en este año?
So, this year so far has seen a bit of a downturn in the equities at the beginning of the year as investors became worried about several factors, and since then monetary policy has really stepped up, and I think that's been a dominant theme this year. Mm-hmm. Central banks with their purchase programs, with quantitative easing, this has helped credit markets, it's stabilized equity markets, but now I think the tide is beginning to turn, and this is an interesting point for convertibles as well, because they have exposure to a potential upswing in equities. So as investors really begin to think that low bond yields are not necessarily forever and can go up, and maybe the conversation turns more towards fiscal policy and a little bit less about monetary policy, it could be a very, very interesting time to take exposure to the equity upsides that convertible bonds have. So we think now is an important time for convertible bonds, as well as possibly signs of a bit of a turning point in some of the market themes.
Y sin embargo hemos visto otros factores a lo largo de este año, como puede ser el miedo a una recesión global, como la desaceleración en China, también el soporte que hemos visto, el nivel que hemos visto en el petróleo. Yo no sé si son buenos factores para invertir.
Well, they can provide some very interesting opportunities for investors. These are difficult things for investors, and I would make two points about that. The first one is that convertible bonds have positive convexity as an asset class. That means when markets go down, they begin to behave more like bonds and offer you the protection that bonds have compared to equities. When equity markets go up, convertible bonds become more equity sensitive and have more characteristics of equities. So you have this asymmetry where in different phases of the market, you have what you want from the market, so more equity exposure on the upside, more bond exposure on the downside. So in those difficult times, as you've highlighted, you have the convertible which is automatically adjusting your exposure to how you would want it. Now, do these episodes present interesting investment opportunities? I think so, and if you can capture that through an asset class like convertibles, it's very appealing. Just to give you one example, in the oil market, we saw the depths come earlier in the year around February time. And for convertible investors who have a long-term horizon, you can have some interesting opportunities. If I think back to one new issue that we had at that time from a company called Technip, when oil prices were very low, they didn't have such a strong feeling for the straight bond market. They wanted to issue a convertible bond instead, and it was a great opportunity for investors at the low point in the oil market to take a 5-year option on a potential turnaround. And in fact, maybe some of that turnaround has happened a little bit earlier than some people would have expected, but it was a great opportunity for investors, and so the benefits of a convex product really shone at a time like that.
¿Y cómo está preparando su cartera para la próxima subida de tipos de interés en Estados Unidos?
So rate rises, as I said, is becoming probably more of a dominant theme now, and the preparation of our portfolio is to try to think whether firstly this will apply to, for example, the European market as well, whether European bond markets will become jittery as US rates start to move, and how and which sectors will respond to this. And the change in sector leadership that we've seen over the last couple of weeks, I think, gives us a clue. So we've seen an increasing dominance of the more growth and cyclical-oriented sectors, such as industrials, chemicals, financials, autos and parts. And you've seen a bit more of a pullback in some of the more rate-sensitive sectors, such as real estate, healthcare, utilities. And in our portfolios, we've been preparing for this shift in sector leadership more towards these growth-oriented sectors at a time when we think investors are going to start to worry more and more about the future path of interest rates.
¿Y por qué este podría ser un buen momento para invertir en este mercado de bonos convertibles?
So now is a great time for convertible bond investing for several reasons. The first reason is you do have this shift in mentality away from monetary policy towards fiscal policy. That could help catalyze a closure in what is actually a very wide gap between equity earnings yields and bond yields, which suggests that relative to bonds, European equities certainly are quite discounted, and they're also a little bit discounted relative to US equities. So even though you may or may not think that European equities in an absolute sense mm-hmm. are discounted, certainly relative to the fixed income markets and relative to the US, we do see value there with the catalysts of a change in investor shift towards convertibles. Now on top of that, we have two other factors. Firstly, the valuation of the convertible asset mm-hmm. class, and secondly, the rate sensitivity of the asset class. So convertible valuations are a couple of percentage points lower than what they've been used to over the last few years. So if that normalizes, we should see a performance pickup for convertibles relative to other asset classes. And then finally, as rates begin to rise, convertibles are so much lower duration than other asset classes that they should be much more insulated against these rising long-term rates.
Mm-hmm. ¿Qué tipo de bonos convertibles están enfocando ahora mismo la inversión?
So, examples of convertibles that we're mm-hmm. focusing on are those with an attractive profile. Mm-hmm. For example, after some companies and sectors have had a very strong run mm-hmm. in the previous phase of the sector leadership, they may have moved more into the money, some good examples being a few names in the German residential sector, potentially quite rate sensitive sectors, but they've had a strong run for a long period of time, and we've taken some chips off the table on those names and have recycled them into slightly more defensive profiles, more balanced convertibles that don't have such high equity sensitivity and have more of the sensitivity that is really characteristic of the convertible asset class, remembering that the ones that had the aggressive profile got there because of a period of strong performance. So we're focusing now on these more typical profiles of convertibles that have these positive convexity dynamics, and in case some of the near-term risks to markets were to become bigger, have that defensive characteristic of being close to their bond floors and behaving more like a bond if markets were to fall. So this is a priority for us in the fund right now.
¿Nos podría decir algún nombre, algún ejemplo de que nos está diciendo de estos sectores?
Sure, so we have a range of companies in our portfolio, and one of the advantages that our fund has and that the convertible market has is its breadth and diversity, and this is a really important factor for investors to consider as well. You have larger companies, you have some smaller companies, you have some highly rated companies, you have some high yield profile type companies, mm-hmm. and a variety of different countries and currencies as well that over the long run really enhance the diversity of the convertible market and of funds like ours. So to reflect that, we have, for example, Siemens in our portfolio, one of the largest companies, very diversified, it's an industrial, it should benefit from these valuations and from this trend towards more fiscal-driven policy and global growth, which although modest now, is at least positive, and we do see signs of a strengthening and a consistency in that pattern going forward, so Siemens should be very well placed to benefit. Importantly, as a convertible bond, it's also got a great profile. It's got that asymmetry, that convexity, that downside protection that you want, but also with reasonable participation to an upswing in equities when it occurs. So it's a sort of a typical holding of a convertible that makes sense to us in this market, and it embodies what's best about the asset class. But then we have bonds with other profiles as well. To give you a couple of examples, one, La Caixa, into Caixa Bank, is a convertible on a Spanish name. It's only got 1 year to go. The shares have had a difficult time lately, but now the bond as a result of that actually yields about 1%. And if you compare that to the minus 40 basis points available at the ECB, this is a very attractive short-term rate of return. So it shows you that there is that real diversity within the convertible bond market and enables us to manage cash and cash-like holdings and conservative profiles in that way. And then finally, a recent new issue by Ubisoft, the French software games company. They write software, they produce leading games, and they are at the forefront of a trend where they move more and more towards downloadable content, online gaming, gaming with multiplayer, and so it's less about selling a big title now, but selling repeat issues of. And this company has come to the convertible bond market. You can't get access to this company through the straight bond market. The convertible bond is an excellent way to play a long-term trend in gaming and in leisure, and with the possibility of even potentially some event risk on the name, which has been an important element of the company's news flow in the last year or so.
Me ha comentado algunos de los factores que tienen en cuenta a la hora de invertir. Yo no sé si la diversificación geográfica o la geografía donde está domiciliada la compañía es uno de ellos y cuáles son las economías en las que están en este momento.
So, the key thing with our portfolio in our fund mm-hmm. is the diversification benefits of being able to invest across a wide variety of countries. And actually, we have exposures to that, a wide variety of countries. I would contrast that with other funds and other benchmarks that perhaps are more concentrated or only restricted to the Eurozone. We have the full range, so we can invest in companies from, for example, Switzerland, the Nordics, the UK, all within the fund, which provides additional sources of alpha and opportunity compared to more restrictive. And so we invest in all these different countries, but we're driven more by the sector preferences and the company preferences and the profile and valuation of each individual convertible rather than having country-specific goals. It so happens that with the focus really on growth and the potential for the European economy to continue to start to do better, we have more positions in places like Germany, which is a big part of the convertible bond market. France is also a big part of the convertible bond market. But the depressed valuations that have happened in places like the UK, for example, with the Brexit vote and so forth, have provided a great opportunity for convertible investors to take some exposure at very compelling levels, and our fund has been able to do that.
Mm-hmm. Luke Olsen, gestor de convertibles europeos de Aberdeen Asset Management, es un placer tenerle aquí. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
Y usted recuerden estrategiasdeinversión.com para seguir las opiniones de los mejores expertos y analistas.